Hello, Andreas here from macOS10screencast.com. In this review tutorial thingy, I'd like to show you more, not really a tutorial, not really a review. It's more a very, 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 very long planned tutorial screencast about useful freeware applications for macOS 10, the iPhone, cool bookmarklets, whatever. Whatever I found on the web could fit into this kind of screencast, and this is the first screencast in this series. I hope you like it, my collection of useful things I have found on the net. This is not only about macOS 10 applications, this is also about iPhone applications, this is about the web, cool workflows, whatever I've found on the web and just isn't worth making a 10-minute screencast. So you could get a couple of little short screencasts fit into one. Hope you like it. Now, the first thing I'd like to show you is called iFoam. iFoam you can get at this Tumblr blog, and you can download this thing right here. And once you have done it, you get this nice zip file here. Just unzip it and drop it to your public folder in your Dropbox. Then go inside the folder and copy the public link of the index.html to your clipboard. Once you've done that, you can go to that website, and it looks just a bit terrible on the Mac. But here's the thing: just drag this link to your bookmarks and click OK. Then sync your iPhone, and then you have that bookmark on your iPhone. And once you have done that, you can go to your mobile Safari, go to your bookmark bar, you can select the iPhone, and this is your personal start page. This is pretty neat, I think. You can pick a search engine here from this list. Let's say we want to search for from Alpha. You can pick it and then select search for meaning of life. Hit return. Click OK on the iPhone, and then you see in the background Yupnup is here, in duty of doing the search, and we are getting the correct answer, 42. Let me just quickly move back. You can add your own quick search buttons down below. So if you want to search for, let's say, Wikipedia, you can click on the button and it instantly brings up the search field, and you can start off searching. You can search on maps, Yelp, and all the search engines which are listed here in the picker. If you got a bit programming skills or just know how Yupnup works, you can extend this list of search services to your own needs. The next application I'd like to show you is called What's Keeping Me. Now, the purpose of What's Keeping Me is described pretty easily. Let me just first install this application. You see I'm mounting the DMG. I'm copying the .app to my desktop. Then I'm just closing the window, but without ejecting the DMG or the disk image, I'll throw away the DMG. Now the problem is, now when I want to empty my trash, you see this nice little error message telling us that the error or the operation can't be completed because something is using our DMG file. Now, in our case, this is very easy for us because we can see the disk image is still mounted. So we just need to get rid of this disk image and then can throw it away. Now, here What's Keeping Me comes in handy because it can tell us which process is accessing this thing. You can select the files in the trash, of course, then search the selection, and here you see the disk images helper is apparently accessing this file. So when I unmount our disk image, then empty the trash, you see that there are still files which are accessed somewhere, but this time it's even more annoying for us because we can see which application exactly is accessing that file. Okay, let's go back to What's Keeping Me, search the selection. Now again, What's Keeping Me is finding the process which is accessing that file, and you see here the process accessing this file is apparently Safari. So when I close down Safari, I am able to empty my trash without errors. The next thing I'd like to show you is, well, sometimes or oftentimes we need to rename a lot of files at once. So especially newcomers or switchers, they are called, coming to the Mac asking for an application they can install in order to rename files on their computers, to intelligently rename files on their computers. There are a lot of applications out there which do that job, but what people often forget, there's an application installed already which does handle this job very, very well, and you don't need to install anything. Especially in Snow Leopard, you can create new services by going to Automator. Let me just choose here, and there is an action called Rename Finder Items. Now when I add this Rename Finder Items action, I recommended to make a copy Finder Items action as well. Because we want to rename files, I won't add this action because we are absolutely sure what we are doing here. Now, as an input, I want to select files and folders, and this action should only be available in the Finder. And now the magic trick here is to go to Options and select this option which says show this action when the workflow runs. So when I save this service now, and let me just close down the window, and let's say I have a new folder in the Finder, I can right click on that folder and select from the services menu rename. Now the action is running, and because we have selected show this action when it's running, I get this nice little window here, and here I can select add time or date, I can add text, which just adds text before the name, after the name, or as extension. I can change the case, base name, full name, or the extension only, lowercase, uppercase, title case. I can rename it sequentially, which we'll be doing afterwards. I can replace the text, which I really would have hoped if they would add an option to say, please, whenever this action runs, show me the replace text first and nothing else. So let me just replace white space with underscore, and when I click continue, you see our the folder has gone and now is being renamed to untitled underscore folder. So let's say we want to sequentially rename these photos here. I can again select rename from the services menu. I can select here make sequential. I will choose my own name here, which is photo, and you see here it gives us a nice little preview of our action. When it, once it's done, I can select to separate it by space, which will look a bit nicer on our hard drives, and when I click continue, these photos are being renamed just as we said the rename action should handle our files. One of the last things I'd like to show you is Click2Flash. This is probably one of the most recommended plugins for WebKit browsers nowadays. You download this from this website, and then you get a nice little package. You install this package. I can show you what this package installs. It installs a web plugin for WebKit browsers. Once it's installed, restart Safari, and then you can go to, let's say, a site which has a lot of Flash content. Let's pick Adobe. And then whenever you see a place where Flash content should be displayed, you can selectively enable this Flash content so that you're seeing it. So when you click it, that Flash content is actually then only loaded. And we are proud that Adobe loves now HTML.